keep this.
It was at the end of the line. Power play shift as well, Jonesy. Smart play. Dreisaitl taking a run at Doughty. McDavid in with a big hit on Anderson. And all backhand shot, score! Watch Dreisaitl. Takes a run at Doughty. And watch Doughty's reaction. He's laughing at him. He's laughing. He's not going to be laughing when the puck ends up in the back of the net. Off the stick of Piotr, they score! Tipped on, what a stop, the rebound, they score! Out in front, they score! Jersey's been tipped in! Schultz sprung, they score!
Velarde score!
Hit hard by McCann, they score!
Lazard out in front, Grundstrom scores!
To the outside, they score! Turn it over, Fiala, they score! Shoots one off the blocker of Peterson, it goes in! Pinball wizard, Daniel Sprong, throw it at the net. This game is a runaway freight train. Gave it away, Bjorkstrand, he scores! Anderson, a shot, side of the goal, he scores! With a shot, he scores!
And 40 minutes have been completed. 14 goals have been scored. What a crazy game.
Jersey, his shot scores!
Out wide, Anderson, scores! Unbelievable!
A long pass for Trevor Moore. The horn went, the clock is running, and the most unusual night you'll ever see comes to a screeching halt.
Do you have anything for me on that?
No, I don't know what happened.
The horn went, and everybody stopped. Burakovsky scores! Hey, hey, what do you say? Andre Burakovsky and the Kraken win this one in overtime.
And Robertson has a break here. Down the wing, a shot, and he scores! The kid's amazing. As Robertson gets his league-leading 19th of the year, and that expression says it all. And the Hurricanes win the faceoff. That's thrown down by Burns. O'Bennington missed it back there. Oh! He checks the Hurricane player, or Stahl checked him either way.
Here's the hit of the night right here. Bang! Good technique, goes shoulder to chest. Stahl's like, what are you doing? Fredrik Schenn thought that Stahl ran him over. That's not the case. It was initiated by Binnington.
Huge pass for Blake Lazard. Long shooting, Forsberg will drop that down and sweep it ahead, but to bring it fell.
This Keystone pops down there. What is happening?
And Forsberg trying to keep the play alive, catches everyone off guard. They go, I'm going to play this one forward. Now everyone's, Debrinket goes down. There goes Joseph. Havnick over top.
Anderson Dolan goes down.
Oh, man. That's how it's going right now for Alex Debrinket. Oh, my goodness.
Right in front of Colby.
What are you flinching for, Colby?
Oh.
Protecting at all costs, boys.
Yeah, get the hands out of the pockets.
What's there to protect?
Coaching in San Diego, and I see the game a little bit different.
This. How does it stay out? The puck on the goal line. Craziness around the crease, and it does stay out somehow.
I don't know how it
what
stayed out.
What was that?
Oh. Whiff, Sid, a couple of times, and then Jake couldn't get it around the goalpost.
You don't see Sid missing a lot of those.
Just want to see if we can get a shot of what's going on down by the Zamboni tunnel. They actually have to replace the kick plate. That yellow bit, a chunk of it broke off somehow. I guess a puck hit it or something. So this will take a minute or two to fix up.
I was gifted the piece of the board that actually broke off here. And for safety purposes, they could not leave this piece out and have it be missing from the board. They had to go back as I was walking over. They were sawing a completely new piece off, drilling it in as you see them doing now, and I got a little souvenir for you guys if you want it.
Oh, nice.
Safety first.
Not the most graceful entry to a game.
See ya.
Oh my.
I got a laugh.
Just lost an edge right there and toppled into the net, so the fans are giving him the raspberries here in Pittsburgh.
Well, more action net front, and it's Morgan Barron. And watch the rebound as it comes high, and he jumps, and it's World Cup time as he tries to get up. And I think he might try to head this right there as he's trying to maybe forehead it in.
Hits somebody along the way, then it's Zizekas alone in front. Rebound, and Matt Martin gets it back on net. Soderblom can't control it as it pinballs around. And it's gathered up by Varlamov.
Well, they are taking a look at the iPad here. The referees, Kyle Raymond and Corey Savret. Matt Martin, we talked about him being all around the puck. Well, one of these pucks, taking a look at it again to see if it may have crossed the goal line.
At 11:02 on the clock, the puck completely crossed the goal line. We have a good goal.
Matt Martin knew he had it. Now everybody else does too.
Well, it was one of the more talked about selfies in Leafs history in 2019. Siblings Patricia and Costa Barikas in this building watching their beloved team lose 6-1 to the Penguins that night. Tonight is the first time they are back in Pittsburgh since then. And yes, the smiles, all genuine this time, celebrating Mitch Marner opening the scoring, Chris.
Oh, that's good stuff.
And in behind the play, Brett Ritchie is, he's lost the skate blade, so he can't get off. Ritchie's struggling back to the bench and needs a tow. And the Flames get a break because the Panthers go offside. Somebody called AAA. Ah, the tow truck arrives in the form of Blake Coleman.
Sanderson saved by Halak. And the rebound, where is it? It came out.
That hit Trouba. Puck goes up in the air. Nobody knows where it was. Now watch it drop way out top of the circle. And then Trouba trying to get it, just hits him. You see all that room on the side of the net? Halak was down looking for his stick. There's all that room. He doesn't know where it is. And Trouba pushes him, thinking it's underneath him. So he's out of position. And then the slap shot hits Trouba in the right side. Man.
And now the Blues to center ice. And Ivan Barbashev, look out, he lost it. And Kreider, a breakaway, shorthanded, and he scores.
It's a tough play for Ivan Barbashev. Tough play. He's got his head down on the bench, and no one has to say a word to him of how bad he and awful you feel after a play like that.
Look out, Aho delays, wrist shot off the glove of Jari. Follow up by Svechnikov in front, and they score.
Take a look at the wrist shot. He tries to play the man, watch. He bobbles it, and then he's going to try to play the man instead of getting himself across to that far post. Mirzy, look, he tries to play Svechnikov. He takes himself right out of the blue paint.
Ian Cole through center, sends that one in.
Oh, no.
And it bounces off of Hart and into the net, and Ian Cole is going to get one from center ice.
Yeah, that's not the way you're supposed to be playing these shots off the end wall. It was harmless. It wasn't on net. Yeah, it's not supposed to go in. And Ian Cole can't believe it.
A cautious start to this third period, and the Flyers pay for it. They turn it over behind the net, and the Devils score in front. And a mistake leads to a goal for the Devils.
Carter Hart tries to bump the puck. Some sloppy play from the Flyers here.
Well, they're missing a big guy in their back end. Centered off Putin, they score right away.
Michael, you believe it? Right off the hop like that, and a play bounces off of Husso. Hits Eichel and he just taps it in. Boy, they won't come any easier than that as he on a roll.
Pass and the shot goes wide from Rosen. Put out in front and it's in. O'Reilly banks it in and the Blues are within two in the third.
It went right to O'Reilly. He just banked it off the inside leg of Spencer Knight.
Vlasic over to Benning. Into the high slot. Bonino stabs at it and scores! That was a floater, Drew.
It was a floater. Floater just up over Thatcher Demko. And this popping up. Gregor's looking for it. Demko's looking for it. Look behind the goal line. Look in the net because that's where it ended up.
Switch up their players. Driving right down the middle is Svechnikov. He'll score! A little puck luck for 37.
Goes off of Doughty's left skate and in.
Power play tonight for the Lightning. A lot of power play time for both of these talented power plays. Look out. Here's Marner. And waits and missed. Did that get a piece of points? He had Vasilevskiy down at his mercy. But there's none of it yet. There's a shot and he did not miss that.
I wonder if Sergachev thought the referee was one of his players. The only guy there was the referee, so I wonder if Sergey, out of the corner of his eye, thought, well, he saw sort of a darkish jersey.
For Robertson, who flips it to the corner. Robertson sent it, front score! He poked it in off of Vaakanainen.
This isn't even a scoring chance. He wins a puck battle, trying to wind it out in front, and it carves in. When you're going, everything's going in. He just hacks at it. It rattles in.
Near turnover by Durzi.
And he gave it away, and Barabanov scores!
Just a horrendous, heinous giveaway. Alexander Barabanov, though. Look at how the stick just betrays Durzi on that.
Montembeau takes a look at tries to steer it, look out, he turned it over. What a chance, shot, goal! Comeback complete!
The indecision by Samuel Montembeau cost him. And there Stadnicka cuts it off and he realizes right now Montembeau's in trouble and makes no mistake about it.
37, now Kyrou on for Parayko, shoots, he scores! Parayko! A long wrist shot!
An 80 mile an hour wrist shot catches everybody by surprised it dropped. It was a dropper. It was a bit of a Phil Niekro knuckleball right there, and it dropped just as it was about to hit the goaltender's glove.
Turnover, trouble. Hughes off the deke, banks it in.
Probably not looking for the pad, looking for a teammate, but gets a break off the left pad, the backside of Lindgren.
Hughes to the outside. From the bad angle, he scores. Hughes caroms that one off of the shoulder and ear of Lindgren to the nets.
I guess that's what he's good at. His first goal was off the back of the left leg. Now the right shoulder.
Roddy Schimmick. Back comes Jeff Skinner.
And he'll score. A collision in front between Dell and Cicek. The Sharks goalie went down.
This kind of thing can happen at a bad break for Cicek and Dell.
The troika for Dave Hextall is Beniers, Burakovsky. Beniers moves in, scores! Hey, hey, what do you say? Matty Beniers, the Kraken, they do it again. They win it in overtime.
The veteran Eric Holla will take the opening drop, and it is the Zaxby's opening puck drop. And away we go from New Jersey. Nashville starting with Ryan Johansson. He comes right in, save made, rebound, score! What an opening act! 11 seconds in.
Interesting enough, the reason that Monahan's gone is they needed the space to sign Kadri. They face off against each other, and this one is underway. Dallas Flames hockey on Sportsnet. Here's Monahan tipping through. Marks him out the challenge. Loose puck. He scores. Following up is Slavkovsky after Markstrom came way out of the crease. He had it open. That puts it home, and the 18-year-old rookie makes it 1-0 Montreal just 13 seconds into the hockey game.
All right, that's it. Strange start, to say the least, right off the opening faceoff. Not see that coming.
They're going to have full of lead in their legs. I would anticipate the Anaheim Ducks will have full of legs in game number two of this series.
Yeah, you have to assume they will be a better team tonight. As the Blues won the first game 6-2, here's their chance, and they score. Achari 11 seconds in. What a start for Achari and the Blues.
Alex Tuck and the Sabres, no doubt, need to make a push here, down by a pair.
And no doubt that there will be some counter punches thrown from the Avalanche. But here's a quick start for Tuck. He scores! Alex Tuck, 7 seconds into the third period. Oh, doesn't get much quicker than that. Back to within one.
Tage Thompson accepts the pass. Dahlin shoots it, scores.
Well, what a start for the Buffalo Sabres.
In that department for defensemen. Rebound in front. Allen had it. Bobbled it side of the net. Score! And just like that, not even a minute in, it is 2-0 Buffalo on the road. Back to Dahlin. Tuck accepts. Richard, score! 3-0 Buffalo. And what a start for the road team. Not even 3 minutes in. 3-0. Montreal yet to get a shot on the veteran, Anderson.
This is something you don't see very often or ever. Watch this collision between Tkachuk and Lindholm. Have you ever seen Matthew Tkachuk go over and see if he's okay? I've never seen that. That shows you the respect that Matthew Tkachuk has for Lindholm, right?
His former center, right?
Yeah.
Below the goal line, Beauvillier takes it to the backhand, and he sets up Lee and kept out.
Oh.
Whoa.
Lankinen may have put that in. They're going to definitely take a look at this. Puck has to completely cross the line. And right there, it is not crossed. Oh, man,
ow.
That is close.
Wow. After reviewing the play, the puck did not completely cross the goal line. No goal.
Toronto gets away the shot. Evans looking for a tip in.
Oh, the goal is right to the end.
Raquel and then Gensel. Raquel almost pulled it off. Well, it is the trendy thing to do now. We shouldn't be that surprised with anybody doing it.
Taking over, center, Nurse wide open. Scores!
Johnson tries to pull the trigger. Save, rebound, oh my! Roslovic denied. He had a gaping wide open net. Somehow, they deflected away. The Jackets coming oh so close to tying it up.
Passes down, Marshall Sobey. Shot kicked out, rebound to line. What a chance there. And somehow missing the net was Mark Stone.
After video review, the call on the ice is confirmed. We have a good goal.
Yeah, I was going to say, are we missing something?
New Jersey just has a bad fire bomb for delay of game.
Bounced in by Couture. Samsonov out to play it. Comes out in front.
And Samsonov has to make a stop off Couture.
Well, I don't know, who am I to say this looked casual, but to me this looked a bit casual. It comes to the net, he lets it bounce off the blocker, and then all of a sudden it bounces through his feet. I don't think he thought Couture was going to keep coming, and he did.
And Aaron's out there, forced out of the zone by Dawson Mercer. Shesterkin way out to play it. He's got to get back. He made a save in the slot on the shot by Eric Halla. Wow. What a play by Halla. Alert play.
Evgeny Malkin for the victory. He scores. He scores. Evgeny Malkin. All eyes on him, and he just brought the house down.
Love the celly, too. Stick in the air.
Now here's Skinner going to get rocked right over on the bench right there, and he's just going to be left there. Nobody even helping him. He fights to get back out on the ice himself, regains control of the puck. It comes right back to him. Dates Thompson, Patton just steps around him and tucks him into the empty net for the second goal.
Most important question, real or fake tree?
We got both.
I knew it.
Slavin taps it away. Omar, 50 feet and now 64 feet out of his cage, makes the play.
A little pump fake like he was going to go off the wall, and he stepped to the inside.
We're all going to have to wait a little while because this was 10 minutes ago. The Zambonis were on the ice surface for their final flood, but one of them is broken down. So the Jets equivalent of CAA is on the scene, trying to get that machinery going again so they can finish their flood. This is what you're seeing at Canada Life Center at the moment, and this will delay proceedings for the moment.
Namestnikov giving a bump, knocked off the puck. Here comes Pustling across. Wide open there for Zacha. And he hit the side of the net.
Zacha had mustard on that, but was just wide.
No signal, there it is now. Merzlikin's going to sprint to the bench. And he's going to dive back. And it sails wide.
Follow
Bluger. He scores. Teddy Bluger gets the last laugh.
And that's exactly why you don't let the goaltender do that.
Get the goalie out. Just get out of the net. Let the player do it. He can skate and get that puck that went wide.
And then he dives again. And Teddy Bluger, what a way to get his first of the season.
How about the way Merzlikins came over there trying to stop Bluger? That was like that Secret Service save. Oh, boy. That was really something. I just get the goalie out of the net.
Into the right circle, picked off, Suzuki delays, shot, goal! Suzuki, Caulfield, what a goal! Habs up top, 2-1. Suzuki now four-game point streak, 5 points in those four games, and a lot of hockey still in this period as Dvorak with Anderson in, shoot, score! The Habs go back-to-back quickly, Josh Anderson. Craig, that is bang-bang. That is 2 and 7 seconds.
Gets a return, lost it to Hull. Can't clear. Hull will grab the puck and throw it up the glass, and he will go. Hull grabbed it and, like a baseball, tried to throw it out of his own end.
I'm not really sure what Hull's thinking here. I mean, that's a brain cramp, really, right? Like, the puck's up in the air. He knows he's got to swat it out, but maybe he's been watching the free agent signings this week, and he wants to show that, hey, I can catch it and throw it.
So a two-man advantage.
Rope hits Robertson's shot blocked. It breaks the stick of Marner. So now it's 5-on-2.5. What else could go wrong?
Robertson to Hintz. That shot by Haskinen is blocked by Sandin. Haskinen to Robertson. 36 seconds to go in the two-man. Robertson walks it in. That's blocked by Marner. Hintz puts it on net. Oh, Sandin blocked it again. Cross ice.
Oh, and save.
Hit the post. Hintz has it. Save made by Murray. He does the snow angel. The puck's still loose. Ben poking at it. And it's behind the net. And whistle dead. What action! Scored, right in! Allen said no! Schultz has it!
Looks like he's going to the backhand, gets Allen, starts shifting to his left, but it's the shaft of the stick and the knob that stops this puck. Yanni Gord with a good move going in, but you see the save right there. That's a good one.
He'll start to his left on Fleury, Robertson, and gets a win!
The braver the bird, the fatter the cat.
Sherratt, Kopp, and Rasmussen. And that one hit the crossbar. A little chip shot from Dylan Cousins, who has two in the game.
Watch here. He's waiting for the goalie to cheat a little bit, and he does so right off the side of the mask, off the post, and out the other way. He had room right there. It's a smart play there by Dylan Cousins.